Hey, Ash Thompson here from Detroit Lions Podcast. So a player hits free agency, signs a six-year, $120 million contract. It's just $20 million per year, right? That's how it hits the cap. Nice and simple, nice and easy. No, nothing is ever that simple in NFL business. It's a lot more complicated than that. And today, I'm going to teach you how. So the first thing you're going to hear about is the guaranteed money. Well, actually, no, the first thing you're going to hear about is the total value of the contract is a six-year, $120 million contract. The second thing you're going to hear about, because agents love to prop this up, it's what gets them business. It's how they make their money. It's money that they are definitely going to get, so they're pretty proud of it, is in this contract in particular, we'll say it's a six-year contract worth $120 million with $60 million guaranteed at signing. Now, there are a few different ways the money can be guaranteed at signing. The first and most obvious one is the signing bonus. That is a check the player gets a little while after he signs the contract that is just, hey, thanks for joining our team. Here's a giant pile of money. In this case, we're going to say that the signing bonus is $40 million because the math is pretty easy and I like easy math, which I'm guessing everybody else does too. Well, not everybody. I've had a few profs in college that really liked complicated math. The second guaranteed part is usually they usually guarantee the first couple years of salary in a contract like this, because the other economic aspects of it we'll get into dictate that the player is not getting cut anyway. So you can just guarantee that money and it's not a problem unless the player does something insane, like head out and get a bunch of DUIs, or I think the NFL drug policy has some issues that can negate guaranteed salary. But regardless, the player is probably going to get that money because due to other economic issues we'll get into in other videos, it's actually more cost effective to keep him on the team even if he's terrible than it is to cut him. So he gets that money. It's a formality that it's guaranteed. Another one would be roster bonuses, which sometimes aren't actually guaranteed when the contract is signed, but are actually guaranteed at a later date. So if there's in this case, I put in a $7 million roster bonus in year three, there might be language that says something like, at the beginning of year two, the year three roster bonus is guaranteed. Well, the reason teams do that is so that they don't have to set that money aside right now. Because every cent that is actually fully guaranteed, not just guaranteed for injury, that's another thing they like to include in there that isn't quite true, but fully guaranteed at signing has to be put in a bank account so that that money is set aside for the player and no other purpose. The team can't touch that money. They just have to take millions of dollars and put them away. They don't like doing that. So they build in these things, these roster bonuses that become guaranteed at a later date that let them keep their money and then put it aside later, which takes us into the individual year cap hits. Like I said, it's not $20 million every year. I'm going to put up a graphic on the screen right now that just goes over the details of this particular contract so we can get into some specifics and you can actually see what I'm talking about instead of just staring at me. Year one, the signing bonus portion, how that works with the salary cap is it's divided either among the total length of the contract, or in the case that the contract is longer than 5 years, the first 5 years of the contract. So in this case, the signing bonus hits the salary cap for $8 million in each of the first five seasons. In year one, I've given the player $1 million salary because guess what? They're getting a $40 million check. And they're generally speaking going to be perfectly happy to take a very small salary because they don't care. They just got rich. They just got richer than they've ever been. They've got richer than anyone that they know in a case like this. So your total cap hit for year one of this $20 million a year contract is only actually $9 million. Year two, the salary goes up a little bit, but not to the full amount. Generally, you can get a player to agree to this because, again, they're getting a giant check. So for a couple years, they don't necessarily care what their income level's at because they're getting $40 million. And you can say, hey, look, we're just paying you the amount that you would have gotten in the first 2 years. We're just paying you that right now up front. And they're usually fine with that. So in year two, there's an $8 million signing bonus charge and the $5 million salary hit for a total cap hit of $13 million. In year three, this is where I got a little bit tricky with this one. You have your $8 million signing bonus hit because you're still in the first 5 years. You have a $3 million of salary, but you have a $7 million roster bonus. Now, the reason players agree to things like this is because it's nice in the middle of your offseason when you're going to go on vacation, you're looking at buying houses, you have time to actually do something to get a nice big $7 million or so check. And like I said, this could have had language that made it be guaranteed the previous season or something like that. So it would have been included in the agent's press release. And when you hear a giant amount of of guaranteed money, it's always the agent who released that. But regardless, the player has his $8 million from the signing bonus on here, the $3 million salary, and a $7 million upfront check before the season for a total cap hit of $18 million. So we're 3 years in, we still haven't hit that $20 million per year. Year four and year five of this contract, I just kind of left everything normal. There's the $8 million hit from the signing bonus and the $12 million salary that the player actually receives that year. For a cap hit of $20 million in year four, the salary goes up to $14 million in year five for a $22 million cap hit with the signing bonus included. And then in year six, there is no more of that signing bonus that has to hit the salary cap. So in this case, the player's salary is $12 million. But there are other kinds of incentives other than just salary and roster bonuses. There are like playing time bonuses, which is what I've put in here. I just put in $1 million per game for the entire season. So that's up to $17 million, because by the time we hit year six of this, the NFL will be playing 17 season games, if they're not immediately right now, for a total cap hit of $29 million, potentially. We're going to get another video into exactly how incentives hit, because it's not quite this simple, but I didn't want to have this video take 25 minutes of explaining every single little nuance of this, so we're going to get into this a little bit later. So this player has received $40 million signing bonus, which he got day one. Over the years of the contract, he's received $46 million in salary. He has received a $7 million roster bonus in year three. And his incentives, he received up to $17 million more in that, taking him up to his total of $120 million over 6 years. And you'll notice there was only 1 year of this entire contract where his salary cap hit was $20 million. NFL contracts are complicated. That's just a fact. There are people who get paid a lot of money to deal with all of this stuff. I don't expect every casual fan to understand this, but if you're watching this video 8.5 minutes or so in, you apparently cared a little bit about this at least. So there you go. Now you understand NFL contracts at least as well as a lot of the people who write about football for money. If you have any questions, comments, or you'd like to see other videos like this, right down there. Comment down there. So we're going to get the information that you need.